There's two important things to remember when you're facing a short putt. The first one has to do with the speed that you need to have. When somebody goes to get their ball out of the hole, where do they step? They step here and here, but nobody steps right there. So after three groups have gone through in the morning, there's pristine grass that's untouched, there's a moat where everyone has stepped, and then because there's less traffic, it's pristine back here as well. So if your ball is going too slowly and it goes down into the moat, it might get knocked offline by it. The other thing is that when putts are breaking, if they die right at the hole, they may break across the front of the hole and not quite go in. So what that all means is that there may be a distance you would hit past the hole that would be ideal for holing it that wouldn't be stopping it right at the hole. Lots of studies have been done on this, and the bell curve distribution is such that 17 inches by, where I have this shaft right here, is the proper amount to hole putt. That's the top of the bell curve. Listen to this, 2 inches past is as good as 50 inches past. 2 inches past means it's going so slowly, if it caught any part of the hole, it would go, but it doesn't hit the hole very much. It gets knocked off by imperfections and it breaks across the front. 50 inches by, more than 4 feet, it'd have to hit the back of the hole and jump up, but it hits the hole a lot. So 2 inches by, no, 50, no, 17, perfect. It's also the best thing you can do on 4-footers. Rare you're gonna get a 4-footer that's gonna break outside the hole. So the good player's dream is to know which way it's going to break, to be able to put it on the top edge, and then hit it hard enough so that it would get 17 inches by if it missed.